Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve the error column count doesn't match value count at row 1 in MySQL. So I'll be showing you two scenarios why this error is occurring and the solution for it. So let's get started. So the first scenario is a table of a column having the default constraint. I think that is when this particular error occurs most times. Another one is going to be the normal table having many number of columns. So first I will be showing you this one. So this is my table named my table over here. It has like two columns, ID and attendance ATT, and this ATT column has a default constraint. So when I just try to insert value into my table, so here you can see, let me just now cut this. Yeah. So I'm just trying to insert a value into my table and I'm inserting only the ID value because ATT is by default, right? Default it gets assigned to 100 if I don't insert a value. But if I run it, like I'll be getting the same error. The reason is because here we aren't specifying what this particular value 2 is going to go or which column this particular value 2 needs to be inserted. We are not specifying that. We are just giving randomly one value. So MySQL can't find for which particular column this value 2 needs to go. So for that, after the table name, just put a bracket and here we have to specify for which particular column this value needs to go. So I will just go with ID. And you should not put here attendance because ID doesn't have a default value, only attendance has default. So by this way, I'm specifying that this 2 needs to go for the ID column and not attendance, which has a default value. So now if I run it, yeah, I'll be getting a green mark, which means that the value has now been inserted. So if I just do select asterisk from my table and run this, I'll be having 2 and the default value 100 inside it. Yeah. And in case if you're having so many values other than this, like you are having another table, another column like that, you can just put a comma and add the column name over here as well. So that's your choice. So this is how you solve the first scenario. And we just now undo it and remove this itself. Yeah. So my second scenario is going to be this one. So this is a table that I'm having over here. It is called as new tab. And I will also have an insert command over here. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, this is the second scenario. I will just try to insert some values. Insert into new tab. I will go with values. Never forget that. 1, 2. Alright, I'm just trying to insert two values. I'm just neglecting the final column. And it doesn't even have a default constraint. So if I just now run it, yeah, I'll be getting the same error. So in case if you have like skipped the insertion of a column, the number of parameters that you are trying to insert needs to be equal to the number of columns present in a table. And this error can also occur if you have like missed a comma between that, or in case if you're having a string and if you're just typing name and if you have like missed a double quotes, you need to just check that. So I think that's basically the most of the times the mistake, if missing a comma or a double quotes in case of string. So if I just now go with a name like A, so if I just now run it, it'll be getting inserted. So these are like thing the two scenarios. If you're using default, specify the column name in bracket after the table name. This will solve the issue. And I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other tutorials in MySQL, MySQL queries, interview questions, C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB. So do check other videos off my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.